In the previous lecture, we have studied about the evidences of the evolution. So, in the today's lecture, we will continue that part. In the previous class, we have taken the two examples or the two classes of the evidences of evolution, that were paleontological evidences and the morphological and the anatomical evidences. So, here today we will discuss about the third class of the evidences of the evolution. Evidences of evolution, in which we are taking our third class, biogeographical evidences. Biogeographical evidences. So, the study of the differentiation or the separation of the plants and the animals on the different continents of the earth is called as biogeography. Study of distribution of plants and animals on different continents of Earth. Study of distribution of plants and animals on the different continent of Earth, this is called as biogeography. So, how the plants and animals were separated or gets differentiated on the various other continents of the earth? Kaise plants or animals alag alag earth ke alag alag hisson par bate gaye? So, let us discuss it now. Earlier, there was only a huge landmass of the earth. Let us consider this as the huge landmass of the earth, which was present in earlier environment, in the primitive environment. So, we call this huge landmass of the earth as Pangaea, the huge landmass of earth. The huge landmass of the earth is called as Pangaea, which was present earlier in the primitive environment on the earth. So, this huge landmass of the earth get divided into six smaller landmasses. These are the six smaller landmasses. This huge landmass of the earth get divided into six smaller landmasses by some geographical disturbances. These geographical disturbances may be any kind of disturbances like volcano eruption or any other kind of disturbances by which this huge landmass of the earth, which is called as Pangaea, was distributed into the six smaller landmasses of the earth, and these six smaller landmasses of the earth now are called as the six continents of the earth. So, by the separation of these huge landmass, six continents were present or six continents were formed, and these six continents started floating on their own surfaces how they are present today. ये सिक्स लैंड मासेस बनने के बाद में जिस तरह आज की स्थिति में वो प्रेजेंट है उस तरह से उस टाइम पर भी सेटल डाउन हो गए. सो सेटल डाउन तो हो गए एंड दीज smaller land masses or these six continents were separated by the by some barriers or by some biological barriers or geographical barriers like seas and oceans and mountains. and these continents also started drifting away from each other, and they started moving away from each other. So the distance between each continent also started to become more and more large, or more, to become the distance between two continents become more. So what were the six continents? The first continent was Nearctic. Nearctic. This Nearctic today is called as North America. This was the earlier name, and this is the name which has given today. Nearctic is called as North America. Neotropical is called as Central and South America. The third is Paleotropic. This continent consisted of the European countries and the Asian countries, some of the Asian countries, which are the Asian countries which are north to Himalayas, which are present north to Himalayas. And the fourth Ethiopian, these consisted of Madagascar Island. The fifth one, Oriental, it consisted of some more Asian countries like India, Malaysia, Java, Sumatra, Borneo, etc. And the last one, Australia. It consisted of Australia, New Guinea, and Tasmania. These were the six continents which were formed by the distribution of this huge landmass, and they were named in the earlier times as Nearctic, Neotropical, Nearctic, Neotropical, and here is the name, not Paleotropical. Palearctic. Nearctic, Neotropical, Palearctic, Ethiopian, Oriental, and Australia. Today the Nearctic is called as North America, Neotropical is Central and South America, Palearctic consisted of some European countries, and the Asian countries which are present in north of the Himalaya, and Ethiopian consisted of that Madagascar Islands and South America, all that, some part of the South America. And Oriental, it consisted of some of the Asian countries like India, Malaysia, Ceylon, Java, Sumatra, Borneo, etc. And Australia, the last continent is the Australian continent, and it consisted of the countries which belongs to the Australian continent is Australia, New Guinea, and Tasmania. So this was the these were the six continents which were made. Now, let us discuss some examples of the biogeographical evidences. Example. The first example which we are going to take is of the Darwin finches. These Darwin finches, as the name suggests, were discovered by Darwin. These were discovered by Darwin when he was on his voyage. He was on his voyage by his ship HMS Beagle. Darwin was on a voyage on his ship HMS Beagle. Remember the name of this ship, and it is very important by the point of your exam. He was on the voyage on his ship HMS Beagle, and he reached to the Madagascar island. So here what he observed, that there were the same species of the birds, they were, which were different from in the two aspects. They were different in the aspect of their size, and they were different, though they were belonging to the same species, they were different in the two aspects. First was the size, and the second was the beak. And he observed the 20 such varieties. He observed the 20 varieties of these kind of birds, which were belonging to the same species, and they were different, or he observed the 20 different sizes of the bird, and they were different in their beaks also. So these Darwin finches were small sized bird, small sized and black colored bird. So when he observed that these birds were only different in the two aspects, that were size and beak, and he observed 20 such varieties, and where he observed, on his voyage by the ship HMS Beagle on Madagascar islands. So what Darwin concluded, that though they are belonging to the same kind of species, they have become the different varieties. So how they become a different varieties? There might be having some type of environmental changes in their environment where they are living. And this was the another scientist named David Lack. This scientist David Lack said that these 20 varieties were developed from a grain eating bird. He said that the same 20 varieties, these 20 varieties have been developed from one single grain eating bird. Ek anaj khane wale pakshi se 20 dusri varieties ke pakshi develop hue. To kaise hue wo? So the suppose that one grain eating bird is residing or have a residence on a island. When that grain eating bird were living in a group, wo ek jhund mein rehte the, some of the birds get migrated to the different continents, and some other also migrated to some other islands which were near to that. So jab birds ek आइलैंड से दूसरे आइलैंड पर माइग्रेट हुए, तो ऐसा कोई जरूरी तो नहीं है कि वहां पर भी वो ही सेम इन्वायरमेंटल कंडीशंस हो या वहां पर भी वो ही सेम फ्रूट फूड रिसोर्सेज अवेलेबल हो जो एक आइलैंड पर प्रेजेंट थे. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस चेंज इन द एनवायरमेंट और बिकॉज ऑफ द चेंज इन देयर फूड हैबिट्स, दे चेंज देयर साइज एंड दे चेंज द शेप ऑफ देयर बीक. ग्रेन ईटिंग बर्ड्स जनरली हैविंग द स्मॉल साइज ऑफ बीक. तो जब उनके एनवायरमेंट में या जब उनके फूड हैबिट्स में कुछ चेंजेस आएंगे तो उनके फूड हैबिट्स के अकॉर्डिंग वो उनका साइज या फिर उनके बीक का शेप या साइज या स्ट्रक्चर जो भी है वो अपने एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस और के अकॉर्डिंग चेंज कर सकते हैं. दे अडैप्टेड टू सच काइंड ऑफ एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस फॉर सर्वाइविंग देयर. दिस वॉज द कंसेप्ट ऑफ डार्विन फिंचेस विच वॉज गिवन बाय डार्विन, दैट दे वर द 20 वेराइटीज ऑफ द बर्ड्स वर बिलोंगिंग टू द सेम काइंड ऑफ स्पीशीज. दो दे वर बिलोंगिंग टू द सेम काइंड ऑफ स्पीशीज, दे वर हैविंग द डिफरेंट साइज एंड डिफरेंट शेप ऑफ द बीक. सो नाउ वील टेक द सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल. दिस कंटिन्यूअस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. The second example which we are going to take is discontinuous distribution. As I told you earlier that there was a huge landmass of the earth. So consider here that this is the huge landmass of the earth. This is the huge landmass of the earth, and some of the organisms are present here, here and here. This is the huge landmass of the earth, and some organisms are present here on the three places. So, when there happened some kind of geographical disturbances, kuch geographical disturbances, some due to some geographical disturbances, this huge landmass get divided into the three different kind of landmasses. So, geographical distribution hua, to aisa zaruri to nahi hai कि इस वाले कॉन्टिनेंट पर जो ऑर्गेनिजम्स प्रेजेंट थे वो जिंदा ही होंगे. हो सकता है वो मर गए हों ड्यू टू द सीवियर जियोग्राफिकल कंडीशंस लाइक वॉल्केनो इरप्शन और सम अदर काइंड ऑफ डिस्टरबेंसेस. तो हो सकता है कि यहाँ पर जो ऑर्गेनिजम्स पहले प्रेजेंट थे देवर वैनिश्ड और देवर डाइड, एंड ओनली द ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच वर प्रेजेंट इन बोथ ऑफ दिस कॉन्टिनेंट्स गेट सर्वाइव्ड. सो या फिर ऐसा भी हो सकता है कि इस वाले और द एनिमल्स विच वर प्रेजेंट इन द दिस कॉन्टिनेंट और इन दिस कॉन्टिनेंट दे गॉट वैनिश्ड एंड ओनली द ऑर्गेनिजम्स प्रेजेंट हियर गेट सर्वाइव. दिस माइट इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल. वी कांट से दैट सम ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म विच ऑर्गेनिजम्स वर अलाइव एंड विच ऑर्गेनिजम्स गेट डाइड. सो जियोग्राफिकल डिस्टर्बेंसेस से कुछ ऑर्गेनिजम्स यहाँ पर जो थे देवर वैनिश्ड और देवर फिनिश्ड, एंड ओनली द ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच प्रेजेंट इन बोथ ऑफ दिस कॉन्टिनेंट्स. सो बाय डिसकंटिन्यूस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन वी वॉन्ट टू से दैट द ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर नॉट कंटिन्यूसली डिवाइडेड और एक साथ उनको एक क्रम में रखकर डिवाइड नहीं किया गया है. दे आर डिवाइडेड रैंडमली इन द डिसकंटिन्यूस मैनर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एलिगेटर्स these alligators are present only in Eastern America and Eastern China. These alligators are present only in the Eastern America and Eastern China. So, how they are present only in these two continents? कि कैसे वो सिर्फ अमेरिका और ईस्टर्न अमेरिका और सिर्फ ईस्टर्न चाइना में ही प्रेजेंट है, वो दूसरे पार्ट्स पर क्यों नहीं प्रेजेंट है? हियर वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट द एनिमल्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन द जू और इन सम अदर मैन मेड पार्क्स और एनीथिंग. हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द नेचुरल हैबिटेट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिजम्स, उनका व्हाट आर नेटिव प्लेसेस ऑफ द एनिमल्स. हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. सो these alligators are present only in the Eastern America and in the Eastern China. How they are present in only to these continents? When there was happening some geographical disturbances, earlier these alligators were present on the whole continent, were present of the majority part of the earth. Pehle एलिगेटर्स अर्थ के मेजॉरिटी या मैक्सिमम हिस्से में एलिगेटर्स पाए जाते थे, बट बिकॉज ऑफ द जियोग्राफिकल डिस्टर्बेंसेस दीज सम ऑफ द पार्ट ऑफ द और सम ऑफ द कॉन्टिनेंट्स ऑफ द अर्थ गेट सेपरेटेड एंड देयर ड्यू टू द सेपरेशन देयर एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस वर ऑल्सो चेंज्ड. कुछ ड्यू टू द जियोग्राफिकल डिस्टर्बेंसेस के कारण अर्थ के कुछ हिस्से या कॉन्टिनेंट्स मेन लैंड से अलग हो गए. तो अलग होने के कारण देवर सेपरेटेड बाय द ह्यूज बैरियर्स ऑल्सो. वो कुछ ह्यूज बैरियर्स लाइक ओशियंस एंड माउंटेन्स देवर सेपरेटेड बाय दीज काइंड ऑफ ह्यूज बैरियर्स. तो इन सब ह्यूज बैरियर्स से सेपरेट होने के कारण उनका जो एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस है that was also changed from the mainland environmental condition. So due to the change in the environmental conditions, these alligators were not able to survive at that island. And where they will found the proper environmental conditions or the proper adaptive nature to the environment, wo wahan par hi survive kar payenge jahan par unhe प्रॉपर या स्टेबल एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस मिलेगी. और वेयर दे स्टार्टेड गेटिंग एडेप्टेड टू द एनवायरमेंट वो वहां पर ही सर्वाइव करेंगे. सो दे स्टार्टेड सर्वाइविंग ओनली टू दीज कॉन्टिनेंट. सो एलिगेटर्स आर प्रेजेंट ओनली इन द ईस्टर्न अमेरिका एंड द ईस्टर्न चाइना पार्ट. द नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल विच वी विल टेक इज ऑफ plants, the magnolias and tulips. Magnolias and tulips, these are the very beautiful flowers which are present only in eastern China and America. These magnolias and tulips, these are also present in the eastern China part and in the America. The same reason which we have studied for the alligators will also be applied here, that due to some geographical disturbances the mainland got distorted and different continents were made. And if they find the proper environmental condition or the favorable environmental condition, we can say, so if they find the favorable environmental condition, it will be easier for them to survive in that kind of environment. Or if they do not find any kind of environment or any the proper environment or the favorable environment, they will die. So these are the examples of the discontinuous disturbances which is a part of the evidences of evolution in biogeographical evidences. The third example which will we discuss is restricted distribution.